Constitutional expert Mark Levin dropped a MOAD on Mueller's witch hunt Tuesday evening, arguing that the special status obtained by the special counsel's lawyers show that the probe is unconstitutional under Article 2. Robert Mueller and his team of liberal hack lawyers know that they don't stand a chance in Judge Ellis's court, so they are running a shady legal shell game to salvage their case against Paul Manafort. Now, Mueller's lawyers filed for and obtained an obscure special status, giving them dual roles as not only special counsel prosecutors, but also as special assistant U.S. attorneys, which could make it difficult for Judge Ellis to hand the case over to other prosecutors. Now, according to Politico's reporting, this special status given to Mueller's lawyers theoretically allows them to rove around and pursue matters outside of the special counsel's mandate. Now, this bombshell revelation may be the key to dismantling Mueller's entire operation, says Mark Levin. Now, since Mueller's lawyers have dual status as U.S. attorneys, that makes Mueller a U.S. attorney rather than a special counsel. Only a president can appoint a U.S. attorney. By appointing Mueller, Rod Rosenstein usurped the president of the United States.
All right, here with reaction to all this breaking news today, he is the host of CRTV's Levin TV, and right here on the Fox News Channel, number one show, Sunday nights, 10 Eastern. I call him the great one, Mark Levin. Life, Liberty, and Levin is the name of the show. All right, so we have this appointment of Robert Mueller by Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein, because right. Sessions is recused. You have been saying in the last 24 hours on your radio show, and you told me privately, that this very well violates our Constitution and more specifically the Appointments Clause. And I want you to right. really explain this to our audience tonight.
First of all, this seed was planted with me by hat tip to Professor Stephen Calabresi, an old friend of mine who worked for Attorney General Meese as well. We have in the Constitution something called the Appointments Clause, and it applies to principal officers of the executive branch. There's inferior officers, you know, like a chief of staff, an administrative assistant who reports to a principal. Then there's principal officers. As an example, every single United States attorney in the United States has to be nominated by the President of the United States and confirmed by the Senate, because our founders made clear that they wanted both branches of government involved in appointments of these senior level people. You have assistant secretaries in departments, deputy secretaries in departments, and of course, cabinet secretaries, and I said U.S. attorneys. Here's the problem. The appointment of Mueller is utterly unconstitutional for a number of reasons. Rod Rosenstein gave him an agenda that is so broad, not a specific individual, not a specific statute, not even a specific matter. And not only was the initial appointment incredibly broad, he keeps expanding it. So this special counsel is different than past special counsels. He's more like a roving U.S. attorney. Also, we learned something today that's absolutely incredible. In Politico, it says several court filings indicate that when lawyers for Mueller's office appeared in federal court in Alexandria earlier this year, they did so not only as representatives of Mueller's office, but they received an appointment, a special assistant United States attorney appointment in the Eastern District of Virginia. They are, in effect, assistant United States attorneys. Robert Mueller wanted to expand their power. They report to him. If they're assistant United States attorneys or special assistant United States attorneys, that makes Mueller, without question, the equivalent of a United States attorney. So what's unique about him and past independent counsel and special counsel is the massive breadth of his investigation. He's going into bank fraud, wire fraud. He's going into Russia. He's going into a number of other countries. He's interviewed hundreds of individuals, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of documents. He's not an inferior employee like an administrative assistant or anything of that sort. He is a principal officer. And under the Appointments Clause of the United States Constitution, Article 2, Mr. Rosenstein usurped the authority of the President of the United States to nominate whomever he wants as a prosecutor, and Mr. Rosenstein usurped the power of the United States Senate, which has the control over confirmation or not. Mr. Mueller is serving unconstitutionally in violation of the Appointments Clause of the Constitution because of the way Rosenstein appointed him, because of expanding his authority, because Mr. Mueller has expanded his own authority with these four now assistant United States attorneys. And every defendant in this case, every witness in this case, everybody who receives a subpoena in this case, whatever federal court it is, should raise the issue of the Appointments Clause of the Constitution and that Mr. Mueller is conducting himself and his appointment is unconstitutional. See, here's the deal. These career bureaucrat prosecutors like Rosenstein and Mueller and Comey, they don't understand the Constitution. They understand parts of it like due process, warrants, subpoenas, probable cause. Never read the Appointments Clause. Yeah. They've never read the Supreme Court decisions involved in that, like Morrison versus Olson and so forth. I have. Professor Calabresi has. I want your audience to know this, too. So, Mr. Mueller, unlike any past special counsel, unlike any past independent counsel, the breadth of his investigation is so massive, it's so broad. By the initial appointment, the subsequent expansion, and now four of his own people getting dual appointments as effectively assisting United States attorneys, Mr. Mueller, his conduct, his appointment is unconstitutional.
You know, that's why I call you the great one. What you say, I hope every attorney involved in this case heard you. And if you're out watching tonight, when this is up on FoxNews.com, please tweet it out. Please use social media. Please make sure this goes viral.
And all you attorneys out there, go for it, baby. I know what I'm talking about.
That's why we call you the great one. Life, Liberty, Levin. It's every Sunday night. I'm going to be a guest in a coming edition with the great one, Mark Levin, my friend. Thank you.
All right, so be sure to share, like, subscribe, and comment down below and tell me how you feel about this report. But other than that, I hope you guys have a great day. Let's make America great again. Peace.